Kinetic.
EA Sports, it's in the game.
I can't listen. I think I'm going to watch Syracuse. I'm not going to watch Ohio State. Penn State. Ohio State's going to beat them by 100.
I can't believe it. They pulled it out. What a call. Yeah,
a little tootsie-lots. A little tootsie. Tennessee, Kentucky tonight. We're fucking walking in Memphis, baby. Yeah, Super Bowl. Playing the fucking Bengals or the Cardinals. Cardinals in the Super Bowl. Myself.
And this historic matchup is brought to you by EA Sports.
Little Kyler Murray action.
It's the Bills and the Cardinals, and it comes your way next.
My mom will be out soon to walk.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League.
You'll see her walk by aggravating me.
Down to kickoff in what should be
an epic 27-minute video. I'm sure should be out.
NFC champion Buffalo Bills taking on the chance from the other side, the NFC, the Arizona Cardinals. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Out comes the offense for the Bills, led by their quarterback at 6'5". That's Josh Allen.
Truly the face of this Buffalo franchise and totally immersed with the Buffalo community. Josh Allen understands what the Buffalo Bills fans are
looking for. Loyalty one-way is stupid.
That elusive first Super Bowl trophy.
Look at Singletary, dude. See ya. Get off me. Fucking child's play, dude. To start the Super Bowl. That's how we fucking do it. Gotta watch that shit again.
So a long play for our first points in the Super Bowl.
No doubt about it. And what we see here is something that we saw all year long from them. The ability to strike from anywhere on
see
the field.
Ya.
How about the way they got it started in this one?
Get off me. That's how we do it, baby. So fucking do it.
Tyler Bass on for the extra point attempt. And it's 7-0 Buffalo.
Brad was over last.
Not sure if they drew that play.
Play a little NHL. Game's fucking great. So I just need to figure out how to play it. Oh shit.
And off it goes. And this will be a touchback. So
I use hybrid
to the 25. Here come the Cardinals, and it is Kyler Murray from Oklahoma who leads him out.
And with the game being played in Glendale, it's extra
blazing this new lead, Oreos.
As the NFC representative,
shit's
in this
cracked,
game.
Dude.
He's taking steps forward every season to help this offense ascend to among the league's best. If he wins the Super Bowl,
now
it's going to
send me fucking $100 a game. It's been too long. That's dumb when you're buying a video game.
Opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while, because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
The former ASU Sun Devil, Eno Benjamin, will
wrap him up, going down.
First down as he'll take this up to the 38-yard line.
Buffalo's up 7-0.
Prime time for
early this gamble,
isn't it?
7.
Go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
You could tell that. Like ESPN owned by the NFL or vice versa, because you see so much fucking NFL shit. It's NBA season just started. It's the fucking World Series, right? It's the fucking World Series. and they cover it for 5 to 6 minutes. They talk about football for 18 to 19 minutes an episode. They're talking about fucking if Dak Prescott storms okay. Really, I don't give a fuck about that. Like, who cares? Like, it's fucking week 7. Dak Prescott's been hurt all year. He's been hurt his whole career, dude. What's gonna change? Jerry Jones just has to get rid of him, man. Cut your cord, bro. It's not like he brought you a Super Bowl. That's just my thought about the Cowboys. They suck. They ain't shit. Hope it's Cowboys, Bills in the Super Bowl. Fucking fantastic. I hope it's Cowboys, Giants, and NFC Championship game. I don't know if the world can handle something like that. We did have Carolina and fucking Duke in the Final Four, and we had San Diego and the Dodgers in the NLCS. Or no, NLDS. So you never know. And they take a lot of pride in coverage. Look at this. Just missed him. That was just missed a touchdown there. Should have taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete. Absolutely no disguise on Kentucky, that one. Kentucky tennis a key tonight. Look at this shit. From the fucking 50-yard line. No.
And he missed it. It's no good. And this will stay at a 7-point game.
Bills Packers tomorrow night at 8. Is a very ambitious World attempt. Series tonight at 8. Game 2, baby. And now, worst of all, you give the other guys the ball to start their drive at midfield.
So here come the Bills out for their second drive. But partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
They'll run on first down with
Singletary. Oh, look at this shit. He's having a hell of a Super Bowl. Just to start off with like a 20-yard ripper. Look at this shit. Get the fuck off me. That's like a 15-yard run. Think about it. There must be higher than
Super Bowl 57. And we are back and
think
ready to go
about
the
it.
Second quarter of the Super Bowl. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis, as always, thrilled to be with you. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. On second down, here's a run with Singletary. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. Allen going to throw.
Oh, Stephon Diggs, dude. Two-hand grab. Just fucking plink. Dude, my offense is nice. I've mastered Madden, dude. I'm all set with it. Only people that can beat me at Madden is people that cheat. You know fucking Perry and those guys are on the fucking internet looking for plays that can't be stopped. They know they can't take a loss, dude. We can't lose. Who of those clowns, like him and his group, could take a loss in Madden? They probably want to fight each other when they play because they know they're fucking cheating each other. What kind of fucking fun is that? Seriously, dude. Shit's
annoying. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. The Cardinals offense ready to set up shop. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0.
I'm not really a big Badger guy anymore anyways. When college football comes out, that's going to be the shit.
the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can
imagine
work?
If they made a college
get
basketball
back to basics
game.
Is usually your answer.
Oh,
and make
man.
Sure you find the guy
I'd
who can move the ball
him.
Fastest
pop
for you
wide.
If you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still second quarter. You get points on the board.
Golf
here,
game yesterday.
Okay.
I'll be playing that shit soon.
Now he's gonna swing this
I gotta get the footage of me and Brad
short of the 30, but he
playing last night out
there.
Here.
Tackle. Nice move.
But I gotta get this Super Bowl
an
one.
Extra defensive back here for the Bills.
Championship on last week. Gotta keep Bradley and Jimmy Cohn's videos.
And they're gonna get him down well short.
Even though I haven't seen
him
fuck
up. Get this to
the
30. Just a 2-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt.
Except
team
at Walmart. This lady is all fucked up looking. I couldn't tell if she was an old woman or if she was my age. And she walked by, and my mom wasn't looking at the crosswalk. She had just barely started walking on the crosswalk. It's like she accelerated walking on the crosswalk, and my mom's sitting there. And she's like, are you gonna stop? And my mom stopped, and the whatever it was walked across the crosswalk. Thanks for caring, she says. Dude, that's Bennington in a nutshell. Everybody's got something to say. I have to cut through fucking the side streets when I walk in the morning, so I don't hear people running with fucking mouse in the morning. Fucking, you can't look at people in their cars. What are you looking at? The fuck are you looking at, guy? They have nothing to live for around here. That's why they all die on heroin overdoses. Because there's nothing here for them to do at all besides sell drugs and do drugs. It's literally like the ghetto. My neighbor Rob says that like there's the Bennington Godfathers that want to keep it the way it is. I don't understand who these, if they're such people. Like, I think Rob's had one too many fucking Budweisers, but
Allen gonna give this one to Singletary.
Look at this town, it's fucking shithole, dude. They redid the fucking Putnam Hotel and all that shit. For what? They spent a exuberant amount of money on that fucking hotel, and it gives me the fucking creeps, that whole area. You can tell that's a fucking, like, something's gonna go down. Someone's gonna get hurt there someday. You can tell by the layout, dude. I hope that, like, kid. There's no deterrent. There's no people there. It's checking a place out on foot. There's no security there. It's just wait till somebody gets hurt and then investigate it. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're not. What kind of proactive shit is that? They're just waiting. There's no way I would ever rent one of those apartments in that building. There's no way I would ever walk on this fucking, whatever the fuck they spent millions of dollars on, this fucking walkway that they made by my house. Dude, nothing but riffraff. That guy needs to take a fucking bath. That's all you're gonna see over there, dude. It's fucking people that are like not really nice people. They need a shower. And they're gonna be walking across there all the fucking time. You're gonna see people maybe for like a year running in there. Oh, they're on the new path. And then they're gonna get a hot dose of Bennington reality. And a junkie's gonna attack them. God forbid. I'm not saying I want to have it, but that's what's gonna happen. They made a big road from here, this trail from here to North Bennington. You don't think the fucking riffraffs are attracted to that, dude? They got a road to fucking, they got a paved walkway, a fucking liquor store, and everything. Oh man, it's like running the gauntlet. You're taking your life in your hands if you go down that bike path, dude. Better bring a fucking double barrel shotgun and lots of shells. Better rally around your family with a pocket full of shells. Gotta rally around your family with a pocket full of shells. That's what I'm telling you, dude. Better rally around your family if you go for a bike ride down this trail by my house, because I see the fucking people that are walking through there, and it's not good. They did that because they wanted, like, now the bums at the fucking park. God bless them, they're not bums, but they just sit there and get drunk all day and yell and scream, those people at the park. Those people that yell and scream and get drunk all day at the park and take shits in the river are gonna just, they have like a paved highway right to the liquor store, dude.
Have a chance to possibly pad their lead.
Yeah, they had an opportunity there and they weren't able to catch. This town's gone. That was like the whole. Oh, look at that fucking dime pass, dude. That was a dime. Dude, dimer. That's like the bitches I fuck. Dimes. 28-0. Holy fuck. Putting a ball sack to these guys. Nice 40-yard fucking zip line. Zing. Please. Can't do nothing wrong with this Super Bowl, B. Got college football today. You're living a fucking dream, dude.
And a route is on here in this first half. So not much time to work with here. 9 seconds remain in the half as this one is away.
I remember getting my cock massages on the weekend from Casey. Was busting nuts at the same time with her. She put me in together, babe. That was the best.
Arizona's offense at the
I remember me and her getting creeped out watching the movie Traffic. When, like, this kid talks his girlfriend into going to a crack house and they're smoking crack or heroin or something. I don't know what they're doing. But they do their drug and they say, let me take a hit when I'm coming. So they wait till they're coming, they're about to come and take a hit. Aw, dude. I love movies. Like, that's a movie, dude. Like, that's considered commercial. I had a therapist tell me that my books aren't considered commercial. Like, I couldn't sell them commercially. I wrote a book of short stories and he said there's no theme. I don't know, there had to be a theme in short stories. There's a theme in each one of them, if you think about it. Go back and read Jamal the Gypsy, the first one. And you try to tell me there isn't a theme in each one of the chapters. I don't want to argue with the guy. Like, you can't argue with a guy with a PhD because guess what? He's got a PhD and there's no way he's going to be wrong. Well, you're wrong, dude. I've been writing for fucking, you know, my whole life. But I got six, I'm going to have six done, finished books ready to be published after I write this next one. And that guy can suck my dick, dude, trying to get him quit writing and shit. Oh, look, I don't consider it to be for commercial use. Well, I don't consider the movie Rec Room for a fucking dream to be considered for commercial use, but they still made millions of dollars. People are sickos, dude. How is Requiem for Your Dream a fucking, they put that shit on Blu-ray, but you're not going to sit there and read Jamal the Gypsy and get a kick out of it? Suck my dick, dude. You're just a fucking hater. That's what that's about. Haters are going to hate because they're kids and fucking probably shooting heroin and shit. That's all it is. Their kids are losers, so Jimmy's got to be older. But guess what? I love myself, and the Lord loves me. I'm not a fucking loser.
And he is going to have a Cardinals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Yeah, I smoke pot, but I got fucking a disability, but I'm not a fucking loser.
They ride with Ward. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
Oh, you don't hear me fucking. Complaining about my girlfriend or oh this and that. Everybody's just fucking bitching. It's all it is. Nobody can just have a good day. Everybody's gotta be fucking having a shitty day. And that leads me to have a shitty day because I have to listen to everybody. Nobody's ever satisfied or happy.
And he's got a first down as a tackle made at the Bills 27-yard line.
And you get treated like fucking garbage. All I do is help people, but I had all summer and I have a fucking dime. Nobody gave a fuck, bro. Nobody gave a flying fuck. So I'm gonna remember that shit.
Now
And I don't write books to fucking to sell them either. I don't write books to impress people or fucking. Well, I'm gonna line my pockets. I got fucking 9 sources of income, dude. Give me a fucking break. People are so. It's all. I don't even know why I bother even talking to like a lot of my friends. They say all kinds of crazy shit. One of my friends the other day, I got 4 sources of income, guy. I paid for my house and my vehicle 100% by myself. Fuck off, dude. You don't give a fuck about anybody else but yourself. That's the way you've always been, and that's the way it is. Every business deal I've ever made with you, I got fucked out of. And you know it, and I know it. Katie knows it. And Katie had to reaffirm it for me. Just to reaffirm a few things. And that's that.
Now they're down big here in the fourth. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault them for the effort, at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on, into a game situation, and now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for them.
Just because you don't believe in God doesn't mean there isn't one. Don't forget that. That's my last top. That's the last thing I'm ever gonna say about it. Just because you don't think that God doesn't exist, just because you don't believe in God doesn't mean He isn't there. So just remember that shit. You're having your fucking scotch. Think about it. Oh, shit, Jimmy's probably right. There probably is a God. There's more of a fucking chance of a hurricane going through a fucking dump, making a fucking space shuttle out of the hurricane and put all the screws together than how this all came together the way it is perfectly. Somebody had to do it. And it sure as hell wasn't you. I love when people say, I'm God. Not me, but they are saying that they're God. Dude. Oh, shit. That's somebody that's had one too many fucking hits of PCP. I'm God. I've heard people say I'm God, literally. They think they're like getting philosophical with me. Oh, look at that pick, dude. User pick, perfect timing. Suck a fucking cock. Look at my sideline, they're going crazy, dude.
If they had designs of kind of wiggling their way back into this one, that hurts their chances right there.
They had to put it mildly. Look at the lead, look at the deficit, trying to make a play downfield.
I'm standing on a corner in Winslow, Arizona.
You're exactly right. It's going to take a lot for them to have a chance to win this one now.
Tennessee, Kentucky, Tudoy.
What has been a one-sided affair from the 39-yard line. Here comes second down at 6.
Takes like an hour to upload one of these. Look at that Singletary. He's ripping through holes, dude. That's what I do too. I rip through holes. Rip through fucking holes of newspaper. I ain't ripping through no veg. So I had to sit back and listen to some bitch after I fuck her. Yeah, it's worth it. Yeah, sit around my girlfriend. I just lounge around my girlfriend all day. We just have lattes and we like to have lunch together and go shopping and stuff. I'm thinking about maybe having a child with her in the future. How fucking cool does that sound, dude? If you meet the right one and you fight for it and you want to have a relationship, that's different. Well, anyway, I'm in love again. Oh, God. I met the right one. She's the one. I love her. I'm so in love. Ever meet those people? Every month they're in love, dude. Oh, it's just so. Oh, the way. Oh, she cups my asshole. Give me a fucking break, dude. Come on, Rocky. Come on, Rocky. Children are just tax shelters, and everybody can suck my cock. I haven't met any, but well, there's some people that love their kids, but like, to me, I see there's a lot of people that just use their kids as tax shelters, dude. Even Uncle Joey, he fucking says that I'm a joint. He goes, oh, I wish my kid was born in December 7th. He was just for that year's taxes. I didn't say it. He said it. And I like, sit back and you think about, why does that person have five kids? And they're like, wow, they must. Then you hear about people getting like fucking like $10,000 back in taxes. And like, holy fuck, $10,000. That's a lot of chips. And then I'm notified by people that it's not a lot of chips. Like, $10,000 is a lot of money, dude. To me, that's like $1 million. $10,000? $10,000 is like $1 million to me. So I'm just gathering. Yo, look at me. Yeah, I got money. No, dude. I get fucking like $800 and I live off $800. If I can live off $800, then I'm a fat fuck. And you guys can't live off $800, like, you gotta think about your waste of spending, dude. Bad for the environment, all the gas you guys waste. Oh, waste of fucking killing the environment, but you guys are environmentalists. Well, confetti's flying, the Bills fucking win a championship. Hopefully that's what happens at the end of the year, but you never know. It's a long season. It's a long, dragged out year. Josh Allen and Kyler Murray embrace for the fucking champions. Singletary has to be the MVP. He had like fucking 200 yards rushing. Touchdown after touchdown. Hope the Phillies win something fucking sweet. I remember this old guy Bill I used to see every day. He's a Phillies fan. He's like, oh, I watched too much baseball in my life. I never understood why he said that. But then I remember my other buddy, this old, really old guy. Like, he loved baseball. Right to the day he died, that's the way I'm going to be, man. Kid at heart, dude. That's what you got to be. You just got to be a kid. And enjoy yourself. That's what life's about, dude. That's why I make these videos, because I enjoy making them. It's my shit. All right, motherfuckers. College football time. Jimmy Cohn's 24 motherfucking 7. And I'm out. Sucker fucking dick. Look at those numbers.